you doing, folks? James here, Steve here, coming to you from the Field and Chariot World today with Western Summer Sports, bringing you Baylor Bears versus Texas Tech. And we know what Baylor has to do if they've got a chance to make the college football playoffs this year. They've got to just win. And, you know, they've got a dominant offense, they've got a very good defense, but it's just, I guess they haven't won these games in style.
Highest scoring offense in college football right now, the second most for yards per game. Their defense is currently second. They have to win convincingly, not just win, but they got to look good to make themselves move up from seven to get in that top.
Well, they are ranked third right now in the nation in margin of victory at 29.1 points per game. So how many points do you think they need to put up? I mean, we look at TCU, this TCU team put up 82 points on this Texas Tech team. Yeah. I mean, when they brought in second, third string guys, I mean, these guys are just busting plays. So how many does this Baylor team?
I think they need to keep that same margin going, 29, but they just need to keep doing it. To let the college football committee let them know that, hey, Baylor, we are third best turnover margin, third best points per game margin. And keep it going, 29, 30, 35 points. Just make this look really convincing to get Baylor to go from 7 to 4.
Now, you know, we've seen pretty much all of Baylor's games this year. And in the Baylor Tech TCU game, you know, TCU's got that high powered offense, and they spread the field. And they seem to be able to move the ball pretty proficiently. I mean, they were up by 21 points with 11 points left in that game.
Yeah.
Do you think with Cliff Kingsbury and the kind of offense he was, do you think they can spread the field and be able to get those opportunities?
Yes, I definitely think opportunities will be there. But the question of the matter is, does Texas Tech have the receivers and the quarterback that TCU does? No, they don't. But the opportunities will be there when they spread that field to get Baylor's secondary spread out. But I think there will be some opportunities they can take advantage of.
Yeah, and as we came down here to the field to tape this for you, we were watching the Ohio State-Michigan game, and they had gone up by 14 points going into halftime. So I'm just kind of curious to see how that's going to play out with that score and everything.
That's
else.
Not a convincing win, in my opinion.
What do you look for in the Auburn-Alabama game today?
Ooh, the game is going to be in at Alabama, so I see Alabama coming out with a close victory. That game's always tough. You never know what's going to happen. But I think right now, Nick Marshall, quarterback from Auburn, has, you know, struggled at times throwing the ball downfield. I think Alabama's going to basically take advantage of that on defense, and I think Alabama will eventually pull out the win today.
Yeah, you know, it's like we talked about yesterday. The way the thing would set up right now, it would be another rematch of Alabama and Mississippi State, which, I mean, I don't think would be too entertaining of a game. Look for more coverage to come from us. We'll be bringing you our post-game show from down here on the field. We'll also have all of the comments from the players in the Baylor locker room after the game. So y'all enjoy the game, and we'll see you later.